The Illuminati wants your mind, body, and soul. We at war! Did you strap up your combat boots yet? Wacha!
Self-destruct sequence activated. 3, 2, 1.
It's your boy Flat Archie 5000 about to hit you with some more of this ism. What we're going to talk about today is the connection with women and flowers, you know, and why, you know, on different occasions, you know, specifically weddings and anniversaries, graduations, dates, marriage, you know, whatever. There was a time period not too long ago, about 20 years ago, the last I recalled, where women had a strong relationship to flowers. The same thing with, you know, if you had grandparents, you grew up and you was 30, you say, for example, you're 30 years old and you remember a time period when your grandparents would have a strong relationship to gardens. Or they would just have plants inside the house. They would play, you know, they would sit there and sing to the plants. They had a strong connection with just plants, you know, plants and flowers. And even during time period of on Sunday dinners, they would actually take time to go through the process of, you know, it was none of that, you know, microwavable food. It was none of that, you know, going out to eat. Big Mama would sit in that kitchen, you know, and she would do everything from scratch. Everything was from scratch. You know what I'm saying? It was none of this, you know, this 2-minute rice thing or, you know, canned collard greens or canned, you know, frozen broccoli and, you know, and all this crap, you know. There was a time period when things did not move so fast, you know, before all of this technology and before the microwave and all of this other crap, you know, everything went through a process, a specific process. Even when dating a woman, you know, everything was a process. It was no, you know, just calling a woman up and telling her, you know, meet me at my house or let me come to your house. And, you know, y'all have yet to even, you know each other. You know what I'm saying? Everything was a process. And along that process, you know, one thing, if you were trying to romance a woman, you would present her with flowers. You know, that was one of the things that a man could do to actually, you know, work his way into a woman's heart by, you know, submitting himself and presenting flowers. But what I'm actually talking about is, what is the connection between women and flowers? You know, what is it? And it all goes back to a time period of the matriarchy societies, where you had herbivore societies, gardening societies, where women would actually, you know, use a hoe. You know, not the derogatory terminology that we see now where women are actually called hoes. I made a previous video on how and why women are actually called hoes. And it doesn't have anything to do with, you know, sleeping around with other men. It was actually, you know, a gardening tool. But the question remains is, why do women have a strong relationship with flowers at one time? And like I said, it goes to the time period of the matriarchy societies, when women would actually be in the gardens and they would plant vegetables, fruits and vegetables. And they would actually go through the process of reaping those vegetables during a specific time of the year, specifically spring. Springtime is when things start to flourish. And that's pretty much, you know, why women have this strong connection with flowers, and yet they don't know, because it all stems back to the time period when women were actually ruling this planet for millions of years. They were your goddesses, you know, your governors, and they're the ones who actually create the law. And these laws were based upon universal principles that coincided with the process of nature. So, when you go to a wedding and you see the flower girl and you see the man, I think it's called a crochet. I believe that's what it's called. And the man would actually have the flower in his pocket, his tuxedo pocket or whatever. It was all, everything is all symbolic, and it's symbolic to the matriarchy. You can see, you know, these symbols, but yet we don't question, you know, how did things become how they are today? And it's due to the fact of a lot of misinformation being propagated, or not enough questions being asked to actually come up with, you know, a logical and reasonable answer. And this matriarchy society is, you know, is the biggest secret on this planet. You know, besides the fact that this planet is flat, you know, for those who don't know about, you know, the flat earth concept. But besides that, you know, the history of the matriarchy is the biggest secret on the planet. And ever since the fall of the matriarchy, women have been resorted to the lowest statuses within society, namely by the mere fact that, you know, they are subservient to the patriarchy societies. Now, when I speak of the patriarchy societies, you know, I'm always talking about, you know, the rising of the patriarchy societies and the destruction of the matriarchy societies. Now, mind you, everything that took place in the patriarchy society wasn't all bad. There were a lot of good things that took place out of the patriarchy societies, but for the most part, ever since the patriarchy rose, there has been no balance. You know, balance existed within within matriarchy societies when we were actually living by the principles of Ma'at. Now we have nothing but war and chaos and confusion and nothing but destruction due to the lack of Ma'at that's being practiced on a, you know, around the country, you know what I'm saying, around the world, for that matter, you know. The flowers are symbolic to a time period when women were actually, you know, working the gardens, which is the reason why your grandparents would actually have a strong connection with work in the gardens. Even after slavery, a lot of, you know, your grandparents may have not even known why they were so attracted to actually going out into the backyard or going out in the front and, you know, digging up these weeds and, you know, using a hoe to plant flowers or plant seeds and have natural vegetables. You know, it's all in our DNA. It's all in our DNA. So a lot of things that we do in this day and time, it has a strong connection to what we used to do in the past. And it never goes away. It never goes away. It follows you wherever, you know, no matter how many lifetimes or how many times you reincarnate, it's always going to be here. That strong connection to when you were at your strongest point within this world. You know what I'm saying? And that's where, you know, the concept or the connection with flowers actually comes from the time period when women were in the gardens during millions of years ago, and planting seeds and reaping the benefits of those seeds to nourish the world. It's your boy Flat Archie 5000. I'm out. Peace.